So let's consider a problem where I throw a ball with an initial velocity of 50 meters per second. But this time I don't say VOX or VOY, because this is not purely horizontal or purely vertical. It's at an angle. Now we know if we can break this problem into two one-dimensional motion problems, we're all set. So that should be our end goal. Let's pause for a second. Not literally, don't hit the pause button, but let's think back to when we first started talking about horizontal and vertical velocity. Remember how we talked about a ball with vertical and horizontal velocity components? Well, these components were just a way of thinking about the true velocity, which was off at some angle. In that case, we went from components to the true velocity. Now, we're gonna go the other way. So what do I mean by that? I mean, we're gonna make a right triangle. And how do we do it? Well, here's our angled side, here's our hypotenuse. And now I've broken this hypotenuse down into what I call components, a horizontal and a vertical initial velocity component. Now if I call this angle alpha, and I tell you that alpha is equal to about 53 degrees, can you tell me what V0y equals? You might have to think back to the trigonometry from unit 1. Enter your answer here and round to the nearest whole number.